everyone. I'm Shraddha. Today I'm looking forward to present you about our group project, that is comparative studies on bacteriocins produced by Bacillus species. Our main aim is to make a comparative study on the production of bacteriocins from three different Bacillus species, that is Bacillus brevis, Bacillus lentis and Bacillus subtilis. Our objective is to determine the molecular weight and antimicrobial activity of the bacteriocins which are produced. And here we are going to characterize the bacteriocins on based on temperature, pH and enzymes. Apart from this, we are trying to produce a bacteriocin from an acidic acid bacteria, that is Gluconobacter roseus. What is bacteriocin? Bacteriocins are basically ribosomal synthesized proteins or peptides which have antibacterial nature that either kill or inhibit the growth of closely related bacteria. These are the secondary metabolites which are synthesized by bacterial strains during their stationary phase. Why bacteriocins are being used? Basically, bacteriocins are being used as an alternative to chemical preservatives and antibiotics. Due to the food safety and quality concern, chemical preservatives are not being used and bacteriocins are taking place of these chemical preservatives. And antibiotics are basically being resisted by the pathogens. Classification of bacteriocins. Bacteriocins are classified mainly based on the size of amino acids. They are classified into four types: class 1, class 2, class 3 and class 4. In class 1, amino acid range is less than 28, and in class 2, the range of amino acids is between 30 to 60. In class 3, the amino acid range is larger than 60. And in class 4, they are either glyco or lipoproteins. Applications of bacteriocins. Few of them are: they inhibit the pathogenic bacteria, treatment of pathogen-associated disease, treatment of respiratory tract infections. While bacteriocins are also used in food industries as natural preservatives, they improve the safety, quality and flavors of food. And they're also used in bioactive packaging. Now, my friend Soumya would like to continue the presentation.
Coming to mode of action, we have two different types of mechanism. One is degradation of bacterial cell membrane by forming pores in the membrane. And the second one is degradation of bacterial DNA by DNase. So in the first step, that is by pore formation, bacteriocin's hydrophobic residues interact electrostatically with negatively charged bacterial cell membrane. So the interaction between the hydrophobic part of bacteriocin and the bacterial target membrane basically generates pores, which causes a leakage of cellular content, that is ions and ATP. Coming to the second step, that is by DNA degradation, bacteriocins bind to DNA and then prevent transcription and translation, that is converting to mRNA and proteins by degrading DNA. These are the steps which are involved in our methodology. Coming to growth conditions, all the bacterial cultures are revived at 37 degrees in nutrient medium. And all the bacterial cultures are grown at their appropriate propagation temperatures as seen in the table. This is a medium composition. We are using medium 41 and medium 2. These are the list of indicator microorganisms we used, gram positive and gram negative. Cross-streak method. Here we are using cross-streak method for finding the inhibitory spectra. Why we chose cross-streak method is because it is one of the easiest method and it is relatively rapid for screening cultures in search of new bacteriocins, and thus it can also establish a spectra of inhibitory properties of any bacteria. And another added advantage is we can also streak multiple number of bacteria in one plate. So this is our trials. By observing those pictures, we can say that all the test organisms showed most of the inhibition. Maybe it is of partially inhibition or fully inhibition. Now my friend Shabia will continue.
In order to further narrow down the spectrum of indicator bacteria, we have performed antimicrobial assay by using agar-well diffusion method. After seeding the agar plates with indicator organisms, the wells were loaded with cell-free supernatants, obtained after centrifugation of overnight grown cultures of Bacillus subtilis, Bacillus lentis, Bacillus brevis and Gluconobacter roseus. Here are the results we obtained. Except for Klebsiella, all the other test organisms were inhibited by either of the test organisms. Here you can see few clear zones of inhibition and few zones where there is partial inhibition or no inhibition. As bacteriocins are proteins, ammonium sulfate precipitation can be used for separation and partial purification of these bacteriocins. After ammonium sulfate precipitation, the obtained pellet was resuspended in phosphate saline buffer and agarwell diffusion was carried out again to test the ability of this partially purified bacteriocin to inhibit the growth of bacteria. Characterization of bacteriocin can be carried out by exposing the bacteriocin to a range of temperatures and pH and to various enzymes. The stability of bacteriocin at wide temperature ranges and highly acidic and basic pH will widen its scope for its use as a biopreservative. Inactivation of bacteriocins by proteolytic enzymes like trypsin indicates its safe use in humans, even though further cell viability and cytotoxicity studies are needed. After ammonium sulfate precipitation, further purification of bacteriocin can be carried out using gel exclusion chromatography. The molecular weight of the purified bacteriocin is determined by using tricene SDS page. This is a preferred method for resolution of proteins smaller than 30 kilodaltons. This method varies from traditional SDS page by replacing glycine with tricene. The concentration of acrylamide used in these gels are lower than other electrophoretic systems. These lower concentrations facilitate proper electroblotting of the proteins. After SDS, the obtained gel was then overlaid with nutrient agar seeded with indicator organisms to confirm that the inhibitory action was due to bacteriocins and not any other factors. If a clear zone of inhibition is obtained at the separated band of protein, it will confirm that the inhibitory action shown by the test organism was due to bacteriocins. Thank you.